something most of us do not look forward to, unless, of course, you're a tax accountant or you're expecting a big old refund check. If you are doing your own taxes, it can save you money, but it can also cost you a lot if you do make a mistake. Financial analyst Joe Burt joining us now with more on what you can do to avoid those tax blunders. Good morning, Joe.
Good morning, Andrea.
Okay, so you've got five things we need to be aware of, and we'll start with the first one, automatically taking the standard deduction.
Yeah, many people think, well, you know, it's kind of a hassle keeping track of my interest deduction, charitable contributions, excess medical expenses. I'll just take the standard deduction, plug in a number. If you're single, it's $6,300. If married, filing joint, is $12,600. So if you have more itemized deductions than that, you need to itemize your deductions because you're leaving money on the table. Don't just automatically take the standard deduction.
Okay, otherwise you could be missing, it's going to take you a little longer to do the standardized deductions.
It's keeping track of all those expenses and being sure you're taking advantage of them.
Okay, the next one on the list, choosing the wrong filing status.
Yeah, if you're married, filing jointly.
Okay.
Married, filing separately. Single or head of household, those are the four different categories. So you want to take advantage of the best one that's for you, because the further down you go down the list, like single, you don't get as much benefit of some of the deductions.
What about head of household? I think that one trips a lot of people up when they're doing their own taxes.
Yes, this is where you have split up or someone's passed away, you got to file your last return as head of household. Is not as good as married filing jointly, but sometimes you don't have a
okay, not
choice.
Checking for errors. I know this is a big one.
Yeah.
We want to get rushed through it. We want to get the money back.
Yeah. If you don't check for your errors, this is what's going to flag an audit. Because the IRS gets a copy of your W-2s, they get a copy of your 1099s, the interest that you've received, any outside income. And if you don't put it on the right line, you know, the right calculation can be made, but if you don't put it on the right line, it could cause an audit, which isn't a pleasant circumstance.
Which could cost you a lot of time and money in the
long aggravation.
Run. And aggravation,
right.
Yes. Also, choosing the wrong way to pay is another one.
Well, what you don't want to do is run out, and if you owe some money, put it on a high interest rate credit card.
Ooh,
okay, get a hold of the IRS. They will work with you. But what you don't want to do is exacerbate a problem. You're short on cash, you know, put on a credit card, or heaven forbid, one of those payday loans or something like that.
Right.
Worst thing you can do.
Okay.
Yeah, talk to the IRS. They'll work with you.
They are very good about that. It takes a while to get through. I mean, they're jam-packed and the phone lines are not
unfortunately,
always...
Unfortunately, they've cut their staff.
But they are good about working with you if you say, hey, look, I'm struggling financially. And I know they do have other plans, too, if you're really in a hardship kind of place.
Yes, they will work with you. What you don't want to do is run from the IRS.
Yeah.
Because they will find you.
They
will find you. No question about it.
Also, filing late. That's the last one on your list.
Yeah, what you don't want to do is miss the opportunity of getting your taxes in on time. This year, we have until April 18th.
Ooh.
Generally, it's April 15th, but because of a federal holiday, which falls on a Friday, you can now have until April 18th, so we have an extra weekend. And if you don't file on time, it's an automatic 5% penalty of what you owe, and 5% per month, with a maximum of up to 25%. So if you can't file on time, at least get the money in there, what you owe, and file what's called a 4868, which is an extension, which gets you up to October 15th.
Okay, Joe, great advice. Where can people find you?
Just Google me, Andrea. Two words, Joe Burt, B-E-R-T.
That's easy to do.
Thank you.
Sir, thank you.